it was in the news that same-sex marriages got allowed, yeah? And on reading upon it, yeah, I found out that they said that it is at the genetic level of people, it's in the hormones, yeah, what they desire, what they don't desire. Now, I understand that Islam is completely against this, it doesn't allow this, but what I'm saying is, if someone's got that at a genetic level, yeah, and it's his choice,
very good,
and he was born with that kind of tendency, and yet Islam chooses to punish him on something that he was born with.
I agree with you.
So God
it
should.
It sounds illogical.
Yeah. So God made him like that, and God is punishing him for that as well.
Brothers asked a question that recently in India homosexuality has been permitted, not permitted. But the law says it's not a big crime that was there in the Indian constitution.
Yeah.
They have softened it, not permitted yet.
Yes.
It is a court case that took place in Delhi. It's not a law yet.
Yes.
There's a hue and cry yet. There are many organizations fighting against it. So it's not a law. It's a law in Canada, in USA, in UK, not in India yet.
Right, okay.
Yeah. And today, there are some scientific research that say that homosexuality is genetic.
Yes.
So the brother asked the question, if homosexuality is genetic, then who's to blame? How can you consider it to be a sin? Very good question.
Yes.
This research was done earlier, a few years back, and later on, what was found out that this is totally false.
Right.
And the person who propounded this himself was homosexual.
Right. Okay.
So there's no scientific proof yet. It's an assumption.
Right.
Science doesn't testify yet that homosexuality is genetic.
Right.
In fact, Quran says in Surah Araf, chapter number 7, verse number 81, which says that do you have lust for men more in preference to women? To homosexuality. Yes. Talking about Qawm-e Lut.
Yes.
It is prohibited in the Bible also, talking about Lut alayhi salam.
Yes.
Also in the Quran it is prohibited.
Yes.
Homosexuality is prohibited completely.
Right.
It is an assumption that it's genetic. It's not genetic at all. How does it happen? I'll tell you.
Yes.
The psychology, they tell us that once you overdo a thing, you start losing the pleasure.
Right.
So what God has permitted, the normal sexual way of life, you start overdoing it. You start doing unnatural things.
Right.
What God has permitted, natural things, you do unnatural. You start doing from the reverse side. So once you get fed up of doing it so often, that's the reason scientific research says a person who has no extramarital affairs enjoys the sexual life with his wife and husband the maximum.
Yeah, but this tendency is found in small children. I mean, you know,
I'm telling you.
Yeah, so I mean, they have not got married yet or tasted it.
Let me complete.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll come to children later on. For them, talking about the adults.
Yes.
How it comes in children, I'll tell you it.
Okay.
So what happens is once you start overdoing it, you want to enjoy more. So that thing, what is normal, doesn't excite you any longer. Yeah. Then you start doing unnatural things. It's not genetic.
Right.
Talking about children.
Yeah.
How does children come? It doesn't just come out from birth. It's not from birth.
Yeah.
Because they watch pornographic movies.
Right.
They watch blue films. It's haram. The parents, the way they behave in front of the children. All this has a psychologic impact on the child.
Right.
Don't tell a person who's born, then he starts becoming homosexual. It's not like that at all. It's
right.
A misconception.
Right.
Scientific research doesn't say that.
Right. Okay.
It is because of the overexposure. Now children watch the blue films.
Yeah.
The channels. Free to air. You know, there are more pornography channels than other channels.
Yeah.
Very good money. So because of the media, that's how when they see on the channel, they start emulating and that's how they divert.
Right.
Who's to blame? The channel.
Right.
Why did the parent allow them?
Right, okay.
So they will be responsible for that.
Right, okay. Okay, that answers me, that's fine.
Marriages, no horoscope is seen.
Sister asked the question that why in Islam, during marriages, no horoscope is seen. Because sister, we don't believe in horoscope.
Why there is no date of birth? Based on the date of birth, you are not seeing any horoscope?
Yes, sister, I'll come to it. I will tell you what Hinduism says, because I studied Hinduism. In Hinduism, they believe in horoscope. Kundali. You know Kundali?
Yeah, I know.
It's called Kundali. Yes, you know, sister. When Kundali, you tell your date of birth, then they say that this sun was there, and this shagun, and this grahan came. This is a science. But this science is not established science. It's a hypothesis. It says that if you are born on this date, then this grahan comes and this planet goes there and this. It is a science, but it's not an established science. It's not hard science, like what we read in our college, biology, physiology, embryology. It is what they believe. It's an assumption. And then they talk about future. Everything what they mention in the Kundalini does not come out to be true. We in Islam are against fortune telling. Quran says in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 90. Ya alladhina amanu innama al-khamru wal maisuru. Oh, you believe, most certainly intoxicant and gambling. Wal anzabu wal aslamu, dedication of stones, divination of arrows, rishtum min amali shaitan. These are Satan's handiwork. First tanibu lalakum tuflihun. Abstain from this handiwork that you may prosper. Quran says, this fortune telling, divination of arrows, they are Satan's handiwork. Abstain from it that you may prosper. So in Islam, we do not believe in this. You know, many a time, you go in a machine, you put your date of birth, then it comes out there. Something good is going to happen to you in the next 1 week. Even if 100 bad things happen, one good thing will surely happen. The next person goes, it comes horoscope, something bad is going to happen in the next 1 month. So these are statements that are made which are so ambiguous. And all this, you know, a parrot goes and picks up a chit, and you come to know your kundali or what your future. So in Islam, we don't believe a parrot can pick up and tell you what is your future, or by reading the palm or looking at the stars. Islam is against this. And many a time, you get fooled into believing that it is true. And there was a research done that once a psychologist, he was teaching a class of 100 students. And after 1 week, he said, now I have understood your background, everything. I will write about each individual person, about his past and everything. But don't open the chit until I tell you. So he wrote to all 100 students details about the past. Then he said, okay, now open the chits and give me gradation. How much am I accurate? Believe me, more than 95% of the students said the professor was more than 90% correct. The secret was the professor wrote the same thing for everyone. These are such ambiguous statements. What we have to realize, sister, Islam is against fortune telling, against knowing about the future. That's the reason there's no kundli required. If the kundli was there, yet we find that so many marriages are being broken in Hinduism. Why? What we believe that we have to choose our life partner. And our beloved Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, it's mentioned in Sahih Hadith, that whenever you choose your life partner, you look for 4 things. Beauty, wealth, nobility, and virtue. The best is virtue. The best to choose from a life partner is a virtuous life partner, not kundali. Whether born in October, September doesn't make a difference. The virtue should match. That is the reason a woman in Islam, sister, is called as a muhsana. Muhsana in Arabic means a fortress against the devil. In other religions, including Hinduism, the woman is referred as an instrument of a devil. In Quran, the woman is referred as a muhsana. In Arabic, it means a fortress against the devil. So if you marry a virtuous woman, inshallah, she will prevent the husband from going in the wrong track. Hope that answers the question, sister.